Not even necessary.
All right, we're good. We're live.
We live. Wait, what episode are we on? Fuck, I keep losing track. I need to stop paying attention to this. No, I think we did 7 last time, so I think this is 8.
7? Holy shit, I'm drunk already.
Look at us. Fucking, look at us go. Most positive, 7 was the last one. Yeah, it was, so we're on 8 now. Uncreative, episode 8.
I just don't put numbers, and that's why you don't have to remember. You know, just put uncreative. Bam. No worries.
It's just always uncreative.
What episode are you on? I don't know.
No. We're not creative enough to think of numbers.
Yeah. That's way too much work and effort.
Oh, man. To start off, we had talked about it was the PS5 and now freaking Xbox. Is it Series X? Is that what they're calling it? Series?
I think so.
This is like the S and X, and like I don't really understand the name of it. Like,
yeah, so there's a Slim.
Like the digital one, right?
Yes. Yeah. And then the X, when it has like most of the stuff stays the same besides the graphics in it. Yeah. Like the S will not be able to do 4K. I think it only gets to what the hell did I read? Was it 100 frames or 90 frames? And then the X does 120.
Oh, okay.
And then the memory is completely like tripled when you get into the bigger one.
Yeah, I heard that the Series S, like the slim version of the Xbox.
Yep.
Still has more power than the PS5, like on paper.
Oh, I believe that.
Which is crazy because it's only $300, and the PS5 digital is $400, and the regular one's $5.
Yeah.
So I think that that's going to make a huge difference. The fact that it's $300 is insanely cheap. That's
absurd. But what do you consider power? Like, what are you basing the power off of?
I don't know all this
the
shit
graphics.
About
so you talk about like
it's the graphics. Like, I think are like identical. I think it has like a different like SSD or something like that, or like a RAM. I don't know enough to like really talk about it, but someone who does know a lot more than me said that the cheapest version of the Xbox has on paper a better performance system than
the PS5,
which is gonna be crazy because like
watching gameplay from both those kind of nuts. I don't know if you watch gameplay on both of them.
I mean, they all look nuts. They're all going to look nuts. Like, I think the graphics at this point is going to be the same. Like, they're both going to be insane graphics. It's going to be, like, different types of art styles, I think.
It's going to be how, like, we were talking about earlier. It's going to come down to, like, what games do you want to play? And do you already own games? Because they're all going to be backwards compatible. So if you own 300-plus games on Xbox, I don't see you going and buy a PS5.
Yeah,
unless you just have stupid money, then you're buying both anyway. Who gives a shit?
Yeah. The fact that games are going to be... Did PlayStation say the same thing about cross-gen?
They did originally. I don't know if it's still...
I can't remember if that was... I think that was... I wasn't sure if that was PlayStation or Xbox that said that first.
Xbox said it first.
Okay. So, like, the new Xbox Series, you could play Warzone with people on the old systems, which is awesome. Because you don't have to upgrade. There's really no reason you have to.
Mm-hmm. Besides, like,
obviously, upgrading graphics and all that
stuff. It comes down to, like, the console players want to stay on console. But still trying to get the performance of a PC.
Closer to a PC, which, I mean, at that point, I mean, the way my PC runs, if I had that console, it'd be running the same. Like, that console would be running just as nice as mine, which is kind of dope. Because,
like, do you even play 120 frames in Call of Duty?
No, I play 60. I don't even push it, because I'm more concerned with my stream quality, so I never push it. Which, even though it might be able to,
Have you ever played off stream, though? You could play 120 without a problem.
Yeah. Oh, I used to do much higher frames, but then my CPU seemed like it was kind of stressing a little bit, so lowered the load.
I does that sometimes in Call of Duty, which is the only game it does it on.
Yeah, Call of Duty takes so much fucking memory. I think I might be done with Call of Duty. Like,
I'm really fine. I've been playing a lot the last couple of days, and I'm actually really enjoying it again.
Yeah, that you gotta like play it consistently to enjoy it.
That's what it is. Yeah. So that's the problem is you come on one time, you're aggravated.
I know.
Because like either you don't know the new meta, or you're like, what the fuck's going on? My aim's off.
Yeah, the aim takes a while to get back into it. Just the movement, Yeah, everything. Exactly. Yeah, it takes a little bit to get back into it.
Except for like those, like, you know, Ark, freaking Grand Theft Auto, games that don't take legit aim skill base. Mm-hmm. It's just, you just come here and you kind of know what you're doing, you do it.
Exactly. That's kind of how I like to play. Like, cracking another one real quick. But
that sound just gives me goosebumps every time.
Ooh, I smell the blood orange.
Ooh, blood orange. Nice.
Yeah, I got a bunch of those.
You have my freaking beers.
Yeah, I kept them all. They're all in my house.
I drink them all now.
I already drank like 10 of the 24 I got you. Yeah, keep up. We get a bunch of
I'm gonna wrap this podcast.
We are banging Imagine on my door.
He's live.
this one is now live 4 seconds later. I am at Breezy's house.
But, what happened? Pick up. Alcohol is my take.
Fuck, what was I just saying? Oh, what was I saying about Call of Duty? Like, getting back into it? Like, I feel like I like games that you don't need to get back into.
Yeah.
Like, Pokemon. I've been playing, obviously, a lot of Pokemon. Like, getting back into that, it don't take nothing to get back into.
By the way, speaking of Pokemon, because I had your stream up while I was watching you play it.
What's up?
After you went off, like, to switch over, it, mm-hmm. like, oh, do you want to stay on this page? I just said no, because I was like, oh, it's like, give me somebody else. The person that gave me to watch, I have no idea what language they speak.
Everyone that plays Pokemon on Facebook does not speak English. It's all different languages.
And that's why that was my point. So I remember someone saying that to you, like, oh, look, an English person playing Pokemon.
Yeah. Yep.
I was like, oh, but maybe, you know, it's going to be someone close to you. That's mm-hmm. I don't know how they base off the randomness. Oh, no, this person was like in Japan.
Yeah. Because the first, because that's the thing with Facebook. It's growing a ton and it has a ton of viewership, but it's not as diverse as Twitch is. Twitch has a ton, like, obviously way more viewership over the whole platform, but they have a lot of different games where Facebook's very, like, one dimensional. It's like, Battle Royales. It's, you know, Call of Duty, Fortnite, Apex. That's the only thing people watch on there. And all the smaller categories are super, super small. Whereas on Twitch, you can go to like the 50th most viewed game on the platform and it's still going to have like 1,000 viewers. Whereas on Twitch, you go to, I mean, on Facebook.
I talked about yesterday.
Yeah, you go to the 10th most viewed game on Facebook and it has 50. It's
I was like, I want to download a game that's just different. So I was like, let me watch one of these really low streamers, like what they're playing. And I'm like, oh, let's see what this is about. And I'm like, this looks boring. I can see why you got 10 viewers, like total for the game.
Yeah, like if it gets to that point,
just like we pay for this Game Pass. There's so many games on it.
I know.
And then like I, me of all people, like you know, Corin, like everybody else. Like even Sno said, I do not see you playing Ark and enjoying it. And then I played it and I have a blast with it.
I know, you're obsessed with it.
So that's awesome. The thing. Like it's weird. I can't base it off visualization. I actually have to play every game.
Yeah. Which the Game Pass has a lot of updated games on there. There's a new game, a lot of new games on there. You should check it out.
That's what made me want to do it because like there's mad commercials now for it. I'm like, Game Pass has the best commercials on TV and stuff. What the hell's going on? I'm guessing it's because that new phone that came out, that Samsung phone. Because you can play Xbox
a lot of more
right on it.
Cross-play games, right? Like games you can play like on the fly.
Yep. And then that new Z2, like the double screen one that tries to one big screen, you can play Xbox on that too. So I'm like, I'm guessing this is why they're pushing this Battle Pass. Oh my god, Game Pass so much.
Yeah, probably. That makes sense.
So I'm like, I'm gonna start like when no one's on. I think that's what I'm gonna do is download a game, play it.
Yeah. And see what you need like. To definitely do a lot more of that. Just fucking you have the time to stream more.
Yeah, but no.
And just try something, just random shit. Like you got even an hour to kill just on a random game.
Yeah,
I think that's the play. You should definitely try that more.
Yeah,
but
definitely, I've been looking at.
Yeah, Spellbreak's been fun. Like I know we talked about it before. Mm-hmm. Like I definitely had fun playing that, and I'm down to play it again. Like even after this, we were talking about it, but it's still a battle royale, so it'll be fun at first. If like we really grind it, because you know there's gonna be a lot of people trying out for the first time. We'll kind of shit on some lobbies, and we got 3 wins in like an hour. We won our first game ever. Like it's clearly not that competitive right now, but it's just the fights are so different.
Well, that's the thing too. Like we were trying to figure out, like, is it because we're new? Is it bot based? Is there?
I don't think there's bots. I don't know if it's skill based matchmaking. I don't know.
Yeah, that I don't know.
I was watching some other people. I just saw Sn0wman in the chat.
The Sn0wman got it.
Honey, baby. Sn0wman, you even look at the snap. We're gonna get you on this fucking podcast. We're gonna get
you. Yeah, we need your input on these video games. Like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah. Your input is highly valued.
Yeah,
but no, but Spellbreak.
You guys should all check out Sn0wman's OnlyFans account too. Sn0wman G18 OnlyFans. You know. But anyway,
now we can stop promoting him for a little bit. You know.
For a second, sorry. Help out friends, help out. You know,
but yeah, I don't know if they have skill-based matchmaking. I think they do, because I was watching Cypher. He was playing with a couple guys that like were, you know.
Oh, you said that like sweats, players. Right?
Yeah, and it looked like they were having like real competitive lobbies.
Yeah.
So I think it might be skill-based matchmaking, because I can't imagine we'd win our first game if it wasn't.
Whoa. We're kind of insane. Well, I kind of am. I don't know.
Kind of insane. A little insane.
I have my little frosty crossbow thing. I'm good.
Yeah, the frosty crossbow.
No shots. Just hit no shots, bro. Can't spend the Call of Duty to save my goddamn life.
They posted a
that game.
They posted a roadmap, like kind of like what they plan for the game. And they did say they want to add more runes. No, they want to add more runes, like the little special abilities.
Yeah.
And more gauntlets, like different typings.
Yeah.
So the test, they're still like testing and stuff like that. But that sounds kind of exciting to have more variety. Because the meta in that isn't like super solid. I feel like there is a meta, but I don't know. I feel like you can kind of try whatever. Kind of a weird game. We haven't played enough to like really have a huge solid opinion.
Like, I was watching videos of some people playing. I'm just like, let's figure out how these combos work. And there's so many combinations.
Yeah, that's what's crazy.
Everything can be used with the other thing. They made it so that's possible. Mm-hmm. It's just how you use it is the problem. I'm like, all right, that's way too much thinking.
Yeah, because you can do like you can do the rock with like fire, and it makes like a fire trail or some shit. Like, I don't know all of them. Like, I might have just made that up, but like, it's something like that. It's just nuts all the combos you can do. And it's like the flying and stuff like that. It's not overpowered. You don't fly around like crazy. It doesn't feel
especially when I use it, because I'm fucking using my mana half the time to freaking shoot, and then I can fly for a second and a half.
Yeah.
It's always happened to me. What the hell? My guy just can't get it up. Jesus, this game.
Man, what's fucking real life problems over here?
Mm-hmm. He's a drink more, because then he'll stay up the whole time, but he don't listen.
Hey,
you put alcohol in that game.
Fucking experience right there. That's a fucking knowledgeable view right there. Among Us, have you played it yet?
So I thought we were waiting. So this is what, like, I've been saying, because I've been offered to play many times.
I haven't gotten to play.
I wanted to jump into it, but I'm like, I'm not playing until we all play. Because I want it to be, like, I think the first time of no one knowing what they're doing is going to make it more fun.
Like, I mean, we're going to know a little bit based off of streams, like watching it, like knowing how to do certain tasks. But that's not that big of a deal.
Yeah. Yeah. So if I actually, like, played it, and then I would feel like I'm more over here, like, hey, do this. Like, why aren't you doing this? Why aren't you doing this?
Yeah. Yeah. Annoyed because people are new, and, like, you just want to be new with them.
Exactly. Like, stop being basic. Like, want to do your freaking tasks. Yeah, I feel with.
Yeah,
exactly. That's all I know though about it.
I know. I do want to get some games in.
Like,
I don't know if Michelle's actually gonna want to play. So I think we don't really gotta wait. She said that, but I don't know if she's gonna. Like, I don't know. It'd be. We'll see. Because we're gonna have to get a big group, which is not gonna be easy to get a big group.
Yeah.
Like, say we have you, Sn0wman, Tori, Michelle, and it's all like her five. Yeah, too. Chrissy,
more.
Six.
We need six?
I think six is like the 10? Minimum, but six is like, that's...
And 10's the max, right?
Yeah, I believe so. I'm pretty sure 10's the max, yeah.
All right, Chrissy, you're in the chat. There you go. Among Us talk play right now, gameplay, talk bullshit. Yes, exactly. So how many people makes it for a good time?
I would say, like I said, if you have six, you probably only do one imposter. If you had two, that you could double kill and win the game. It's like, you'd have to do one imposter. But if you have like 8 to 10, you could do two probably, which would be fun as hell.
She's playing right now solo, just for randoms.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she is.
We could always try to just play some games like with some randoms, but I don't know.
I would think
it'd be way more fun with like, having a Discord and like, or like an Xbox chat where everyone's muted.
All right, so let's figure out now. We got like four of us right here. So we got me, you.
I got the 137 guys I can get. I can get a bunch of people from there. I can get Lonnie and Jacuzzi and like those guys I talked to. Lonnie?
Or Jacuzzi? We got played in Jacuzzi?
Jacuzzi, the other guy I talked to. He's huge. Like, they're both big TikTok guys. They're big on, like, other things, too.
Until TikTok gets shut down.
No, that'll still be fine. Lonnie got, like, fucking 150,000 on Instagram. He's crushing it.
Yeah, see, I have no idea what Chrissy just said. That's a whole nother language to me.
What'd she say?
Something about speed kills and speed kills 5 seconds to get fun. And then
it's because you can adjust all the settings, which is kind of awesome. Yeah. So like you can adjust the cooldown between kills. I think speed killing is probably assuming like instead of having like 25 seconds of a cooldown, it's like 10 or 5.
Yep.
So you can kill like you do like a lot in a short period of time, which that does sound fun. But we could definitely get a group. But I think you're right. I think we should try it like all the people together, like for that first time.
Yeah,
I think that would definitely be the most fun. What other games are out recently? I never played Fall Guys.
Much fun. I don't care what you say. Sn0wman got pissed off a lot because I kept like creeping him because I was a dick. But like, I feel it's not a game. I don't know if people play that by themselves for hours. That I don't understand.
Yeah, I could see it being like a game with like a couple friends and you're drunk just fucking around. That's the idea.
And like, get your mind off all the other games. Like, it's just something different to like chill with.
Yeah, I think Among Us will be actually, like, super competitive.
Which oh, kinda... hell yeah. We're going to end up friends. We're going
to
like.
I know. I'm kind of nervous to play because I feel like I don't know if I can play with Michelle. I think we'll get into a fight.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
If like if I accuse her and she's not the imposter or something like that and I get her voted off, she's going to fucking
sleep on the couch.
I'm going to sleep on the couch. Like, fact, she won't. She is so competitive that like if I ever did that, she'd be like, you fucking go get me ice cream now. Like, yep, that's it.
You're just gonna have to have a stack. Like,
yeah, I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna give you some treats and like fucking keep you happy all day. And like, just I'm gonna have to agree with her every single time. Never accuse her of anything.
So you legit see her kill somebody, and you're just like, nope, nope. Happy life, happy life. Not doing it. And maybe she just play. Yeah, it's probably a place on you live with. I guess you know.
I know that might be the play.
To make it worse.
Are there any games coming out that you've seen that you want to try? Not big or small games, like. There's still that fucking, it's like street soccer game. I know I pointed it out to you before.
Hey, tell me it. Yeah, you said it's not out yet, though.
It I was asking for like a code or something like that.
Yeah.
Let me see real quick. It's the same company that made that game made Ark, actually.
Oh, okay.
Reverb so Games, apparently.
Oh, so it's got to be a bunch of like just random lag spikes and just not work. People out the window.
Oh, no, that's not what I'm saying. Saying there's another game they made. It's called Move or Die, which actually looks really fucking fun. It's like a 4-player like side-scrolling fighting game, but you can't like stand still. Not like Mortal Kombat. It's more
Christy has it. Why wouldn't she have it? She has that too.
It's
shocker. Christy, go look at the sun. I don't know if you've seen this thing outside called the sun. All right. God, I thought I was a nerd. Every game we talk about, she already has.
But no,
real streamer in the family.
It's like I'm trying to think of like a game. It's kind of like Smash, like how Super Smash Bros. Is, but it's like a more like it's a smaller version of that. But it's you have to keep moving.
Whoa!
If you stop moving, you die.
I'd start Snow. You sound like a robot.
Yeah. Hey, Snowman's here.
Robot version.
Told you.
Why is that bad? Though?
I don't know. This mic is weird.
All
right, that's fine.
Robot Snow to join the party.
Did you watch the PS5 thing?
I did not. I'm an Xbox guy.
All right, I didn't watch it either, but I saw that the Xbox is cheaper than the cheapest PS4 or PS5, and I was like, "Huh, that makes sense. It's still gonna be better."
I see the specs, so I'm going straight Xbox.
Yeah.
Okay, see, that's what I mean. He's gonna go with the spec things. I think he knew details.
Yeah, I don't really understand the details.
But like I said, the only reason why I said I was going to get a PlayStation would be because I have the PC to do mostly all the Microsoft games. And I don't own a million at all. I own every free game.
Okay, just try to flex up me for not owning games. Jeez, sorry.
No, just the whole opposite. You have like 25 hard drives to hold games. Well, you have one hard drive just for Call of Duty.
Yep. Two hard drives just for Call of Duty. One's for the DLC.
DLCs.
Call of Duty. I think I'm gonna fucking uninstall it. It's just takes too much space. And I never play it.
I have fun. I've been having fun with it again. Like I said, it sucks because like I feel we've lost how good we were.
Yeah, but maybe we should want us three to play later. I was gonna get on Spellbreak. I do want to do some more of that, but you know.
Do that too. Like I said, I'm down playing whatever. I like changing it up because it's fun. But like I think what problem with us is we get so hooked, and I'm totally guilty of this. Get so hooked to one game.
Mm-hmm.
That you don't want, like, we just don't want to keep grinding it. Like, right now, like, we start doing stuff on Ark. I just want to keep going until, like, we finish what I plan on doing.
Yeah.
Instead of, like, you know what, just take a break for a little bit. Let's go play Call of Duty. Let's go play Spellbreak. Hell, let's go play fucking Fortnite. I don't care. Yeah. Just to change it up. But
see, when I played Call of Duty, I ended up getting bored and just trying random stupid weapons, and that's what ended up getting me killed a lot.
I know. Yeah, I like doing that.
We had fun that time.
Yeah, I had fun doing that.
Weapons and shit. I feel we had fun doing that. You just can't let, like, you dying. Effect.
Yeah, that's true.
I think that's what it is. Us three, when we play,
gets in the way.
Yeah, I have the most fun when it's us three playing.
Yeah,
like I get the least angry.
Let's not go there.
What?
Me?
You cut me from the team.
I cut you from the team. Oh my god.
That is true.
I wasn't.
You said you could be replaced in a heartbeat. I remember you saying that.
I don't think I said those words. I think it was worse than that.
Oh god.
I think I said his kill death wasn't good enough or some shit. I was like, you fucking suck.
Warzone to be a very solid VR.
Oh, hold on. He wasn't saying this yesterday. Hold on, Oscar. This is going to go.
What?
A solid VR.
To be a very solid VR. Like, I find it to be the worst of all the ones I've played so far. It's still fun, don't get me wrong.
Yeah. It's.
I wish I was streaming yesterday so I could record what he said yesterday.
Well, my problem with it, I realized this when I played Spellbreak.
Well, what did I say yesterday
about Warzone? You were just shitting on it because of Blackout. I love it every time you bring Blackout.
But
into
the
it.
Thing with it that I think is Blackout whack. Is
so much better.
I don't like that you can get loadouts. As much as I do like it.
Also don't like Wait, the hold building on, hold your own on. Gun either.
Yeah, like I like that you, you know, can get loadouts because it's obviously convenient, but I also don't like it because it's very easy. So it's like you don't, it's the battle royale aspect of dropping in and finding what you can. And like Sn0wman said, building a gun with getting different scopes and stuff like that. Like, I feel like that's the part of a battle royale that's kind of crazy. Whereas in Warzone, you survive for 30 seconds, you have enough money, you buy a loadout, you have your whole kit, you have exactly what you want. Which I feel like kind of takes a lot of the fun out of it.
You just have to beat other players that might.
There wouldn't be a meta if they didn't have loadouts.
Of course it would be, because then it would be whatever drop weapon was the meta.
Yeah, but one person might get
right now when you
first
land in, the meta is grab the origin before everybody else. That's the meta right now. Grab the origin and you'll beat everybody.
Yeah, but it's, I don't know. Like, yeah, early game, there's certain guns that are strong, but it's like, it's not the same as people got built origins that are absurd now.
Oh, and I get that, but like, then you have your built whatever you're going against it with. So now it's your choice. It's just like you play multiplayer. It's your choice versus their choice. Which one's a better choice?
But I think,
like you said, you could fight me, and I'd only have like a Graw or I use M13.
Yeah, I'm gonna lose still that fight. Like Fortnite had metas and shit too. Like, it's not like there wouldn't be a meta of some sort.
Yeah, one blue pump, bro. One pump kill.
But now it's like half or 90% of the lobby all has the same gun because it's one gun super strong. Whereas if you play in like Fortnite or I don't know how Black Ops was exactly, but you know there might be two or three people that found the good gun that's super overpowered, but it's not every single person you fight.
Blackout had different guns for different situations. Not one gun excelled in every area. There was ARs that were built like SMGs, so you know you'd kind of have decent range, but you'd be deadly up close.
Yeah.
So it wasn't one thing fits all.
Yeah, which is, I think that's the goal that every game should try to get, is any game with guns should not have a blatant strongest. It should all have their purpose and be balanced. And I don't, Call of Duty's god awful at balance.
Fortnite's god awful or Call of Duty's god
awful? Call of Duty.
Why do you say that?
Because every week that they have an update, there's one gun that ends up being super overpowered and everyone uses it.
I was saying, like, without there being an update, when it goes, like, there was a while before where we had no update and, like, yeah, the Graw was overpowered. That era.
The Graw was absurdly overpowered.
The Graw before the Bruin came out.
The assault rifles in general.
Do you think it was overpowered, really, though?
The Bruin?
Like, yeah, it was strong, but I still felt that I could beat people with my M13 over the Graw.
Yeah, but the it's like the M13, the Kilo, the M4, the Graw, the Bruin, those guns that
well,
you
like
can
you said,
full
they, like,
spray from a mile away and hit every single shot. That
like, exactly, so that's
stupid.
Different. So if someone has a Graw, it's stronger. Bruin hits even harder. Yeah. M13 doesn't bounce as much. Like they still yeah. kind of what you're saying. They still all have their purpose.
But I mean,
I get they're still overpowered. Barely. They all need to be reduced. But they still have all their purpose in a way. Because I still like if you have to bring. Okay, I'm trying to think of guns.
What's the purpose of the AK-47?
To have an AK-47.
That's it. It's useless compared to the other five.
Yeah,
that's
fucking recoil on it. I played a couple of games when we had that challenge. I used the AK because I thought it was fun, but it's just like
that's the problem.
If you could compensate for the recoil, you're fine. It's definitely stronger. I felt it was definitely stronger than the other guns I used.
But the rate of fire is slower.
Yeah, and the fact it went straight in the air, so you shot it instantly.
Blast by the.
You have to notice you forward too, though, right?
But it's so much
fire,
stronger.
Yeah, but it has a higher damage.
Yeah. Oh, exactly. So yeah, so it's either one or the other. Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, the AK should have a purpose where in a certain position it would be better than an M4. Whereas there's no situation where it's better than an M4 or a Graw or like one of those overpowered guns. There's no situation where the AK is better than one of those guns. It's just if you like an AK, you want to use it.
The way to solve this would be giving the AK more damage against body armor.
Yeah, something like that. Like, there's got to be something.
Bullet, it's going to hurt your armor plate more.
Yeah.
I've said this before. I think, like, the size of the bullet should make a difference in the game. I've said that so many times. That and the whole melee damage needs to go out the fucking window.
Yeah, that's annoying.
Yeah.
They can get pissed off twice
anything,
and die.
Like, if you want to do melee damage, like, with a bigger gun and hurt, okay. Like, right now, damage with a pistol our fist in hand should be hitting someone with a fucking Bruin across the head, should feel like.
Yeah.
We talked about it yesterday. That was exactly the same thing.
Yeah, like that. Yeah. I never really liked melee attacks in video games, honestly.
Like, it's stupid. Like we all talked about, we all had the same situation yesterday. We all landed, shooting people point blank, breaking shields, and these people are running straight at us. Fisting, like the missing most of the time, and then they hit us, you're dead. As soon as they hit you, you're dead.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, how logical is this? Like, I get it's a video game. 100% get it's a video game. But put some common sense into it. No way you're going to be running through bullets.
If you're getting melee from behind, fine, whatever.
The 100%, 100%, I agree. I like that aspect. I love the bet, like, get hit from behind, they don't know you're there. Do as much damage as possible, because it's cool. That's just stupidity, not hearing footsteps.
Yeah, but if you see a punch coming, and you get killed
exactly,
in one shot.
Exactly, you're shooting through somebody. That's like, what the hell?
If somebody's punching you, and you're unloading a 9mm into their chest, you should win that fight.
Right, yeah. I'll text you.
Every single time.
So,
if that guy's Muhammad Ali or Mike Tyson, you're still going to win that fight.
Yeah, or Paul Logan, you know what I'm saying? Well, fuck survives everything.
All right, we're going to place you on next podcast.
I just saw that today. It's the only reason why I said it. Apparently, Paul Logan's fighting Mayweather this year. Don't know if you guys saw that. Yeah, that little, like, he was just a streamer.
Logan Paul.
Logan Paul,
oh, no, I call Paul Logan. No, he's called Paul Logan.
Who the fuck's Paul Logan?
Bitch. That's him. Same guy.
Oh,
I don't call him Logan Paul.
I was so confused. Who the fuck's Paul?
Sorry. I heard someone else start that and they made fun of him, so
no,
I just kept.
No, one of those, I don't know if it's Logan Paul or the other guy, the brother. Jake Paul? One of those is fighting Nate Robinson.
That one I saw too, yeah.
Wait, did they already fight?
Mayweather. Well, I don't know.
Yep. Are you taking the Tyson,
Ooh.
Nice fight coming up.
Mike Tyson's fighting Roy Jones Jr.
Jesus. What's the odds? I'm not a gambler.
I gotta go with him, but Mike Tyson has one hell of a punch.
But Mike Tyson's Mike Tyson, you know? It's like Mike Tyson's Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson wanted to fight a baboon, so, you know. Yes,
that's a... Whew. They're old, so it's like kind of hard to tell.
Yeah.
It's like, they're both like 50.
Yeah, but they're old, but like, would you fight them?
I don't know, they'll kill me. They could be like on their deathbed and kill me with a left hook. You think I'm fucking gonna fight them and they're 50 something years old? Hell no.
Wheelchair coming at you, still scared shit.
Hell
like,
no,
yeah. Good,
dude,
bro.
Hell, I would never, never take a punch from one of them. Never.
Not the fighting.
How much money I had.
What did you say, Snowman?
Another rule about to fight a guy that owns a tiger.
Yeah. Fucking Mike Tyson had tigers. The story,
nothing?
When he was on Joe Rogan's podcast and he told a story about why he got tigers, I fucking realized this dude's a psychopath.
So what was the reason? I actually don't know the reason. What is it?
He was in jail. And
all right, we have Simon Compton.
He was on the phone with like his agent and he was talking about how like Pablo Escobar had like crazy exotic animals. And his guy was like, yeah, you know, I can get tigers for you. So he's like, I can get tigers? He's like, that's fucking awesome. Buy me some. So he bought tigers from the phone in jail. He had his agent go buy him some tigers. So when we got out of jail, he had tigers. And he had it, like, on a leash in his backyard.
Let's go get tigers.
So what's the big deal about tigers, though?
Do you know what a tiger is?
I know what a tiger is, but, like, I've seen videos. I've known people, like, I even have friends that's what they do. And they, like, put it on their Instagram and Snap that they raising baby tigers in these bad countries that, like, they're hunting them.
Yeah.
And then, like, there's these little friendly big cats. Like, you're a cat guy. I fucking hate cats.
I also ask you for a few $1,000 every month to free up the funds.
No. They lived here, and they moved to, like, one lives in South Africa right now. And then they came back, and they're like, I kind of want to go back there because it's less drama. I'm like, I get it. You have to worry about a tiger eating your face, and it changes its mind, but no big deal.
I know. If you piss it off, you step on its fucking toe, you're dead. Over.
But no, like, they legit, like, no, yeah, but, like, it's weird, like, they legit post videos of, like, yeah, don't get me wrong, they do work for, like, one of those, like, humane society places that, like, donate to make us, you know, work longer.
Yeah.
But the video she posts, I'm like, yo, these real, or this, like, some, like, this an acting tiger? She's like, no, like, I will straight up send you videos of me out in the wild with these motherfuckers. There's some that would, like, I've got scars on me from them. Like you're saying, I mean, they are
you get a
bad
scratch,
ones.
It's not a little cat
but
scratch.
That one, I guess, they rescued, like, it was, like, I guess, getting attacked by... what it was, like a wolf or something stupid, like was attacking it because the parents were nowhere to be found, maybe poached, and then the baby was still like in the den. and then they've rescued it, and then now it's like a fucking just a big ass cat. I wonder if I'm allergic to it. If I'm not allergic to it, I'll get a tiger.
Yeah, that's the problem.
That's the problem. Yeah, the sniffles. The sniffles are the problem.
Before anything else yeah, does. It would fuck be it. The goddamn allergy.
Fuck it. I'll take the death threat at all times compared to a sniffle. Oh
yeah,
my
yeah,
god.
Yeah. Well, you might be able to cut my throat open in one slice, but wait, can I sleep without like fucking being, you know, stuffed up? Are we good? My eyes not getting watery.
Oh my god.
What? It's logic, bro. It's logic.
Okay. Alright. We've been at this for about 30 minutes or so. You want to keep going?
It's just hit 30. This is a good one. All right,
I'm gonna hit the bathroom first, though. Let me go to the bathroom. And
I'll
be right back.
This will
be our intermission. This will be our intermission to the next episode. This will be two whole episodes. Okay.
So intermission because someone can't handle the seltzers. Okay.
Okay. I gotta break the seal. All right. I actually broke the seal already.